Hey guys! This is the ultimate Unity tutorial for all of you replay people. This tutorial only uses one script and is very simple. So, open your project and let's get coding. I just created an empty project. So, I'm going to need something for the camera to look at. In this case, I just created a sphere, squished it, and added a constant force component to it. Next, you'll want to make sure your camera has a unique tag. In this case, my main camera is already tagged main camera, so that's fine. Okay, we're almost at the coding segment. Right-click in your hierarchy, and under 3D, select the quad button. Now, create a new script, and call it, ReplaySystem. Once you have opened up your new script, create the variables you see on the screen. It's pretty basic, so I won't waste time explaining it. But, there are explanations in the description if you need to know. Next, in the start method, you'll want to set the thisCam variable to thisGameObject's camera component. And now it's probably time I explain how the replay system is going to work. The first step will be saving every frame the camera can see into a list. Then, when we want to watch our replay, we can display every saved frame onto that quad we made earlier. And that's it. So, let's create some methods. The first will be called start recording. Where, as the name suggests, we will start recording what our camera can see into our list. The second method to make will be called stop recording. Which, as you could probably guess, stops recording what the camera can see. The next method you'll want to make is called record frame. This method will be responsible for calling on this next method we will make. Just three more. This next one is very important. Call it capture frame. Instead of writing void, you write texture2D. This will be crucial in later steps. This method records what the camera can see. Make another method and name it display frame. Later, this will display our replay onto that quad we made earlier. The last method you'll need to make will be called start playback. This will start going through the saved frames and displaying them. In the update method, I'm going to make it very easy to call the start recording method, the stop recording method, and of course the start playback method. I used simple button inputs, but you can call these methods anywhere at any time, in any way you know how. Next, you'll want to make the late update method. And inside of it, you need to call the record frame method. Next, in the start recording method, we will want to clear all of the frames we may have had from an earlier replay, and set is recording to true. In the stop recording method, it's as easy as setting the is recording variable to false. Next, we'll learn how to capture the current view of our main camera and return it as a 2D texture. This can be useful for creating screenshots or custom camera effects. We start by saving the current render texture to restore it later. Next, we set the active render texture to the main camera's target texture, redirecting the rendering output. We create a new texture with the same dimensions as the target texture to store the captured image. Then, we read the pixels from the target texture and apply them to our new texture. After that, we restore the original render texture setting. Finally, we return the captured frame as a 2D texture. And that's all you have to do with this method. Now, in the record frame method, you'll want to write the small line of code that goes like this. If is recording texture2D frame equals capture frame, then write frames.add and inside the parentheses write frame. If you've made it this far, I'm very impressed. We're getting close to the end. Next, you'll want to create a new coroutine and call it playback, and inside of it write the code you see on screen. Basically, what this code does is, goes through every frame that's been saved, and calls on our display method to render the image onto the quad. Then it waits for a specified amount of time, before calling on the method again. Then after that, we set isPlaying to false. Speaking of our display frame method, let's write some code inside of it to render the image onto our quad. Lastly, we need to fill out our startPlayback method. We'll write if isPlaying equals false. And frames.count is greater than 0. Then, start coroutine, playback. Next, head back over to Unity, and attach the script you just made to your camera. This is the last step. Right-click in your assets folder and create a new render texture. Then, drag it into the target texture slot on your camera. Also, don't forget to drag your quad into the quad renderer variable that we made earlier. And that's it. You should now have a working replay system. Let's test it out. So, first, I'll press the R button to start recording. Then I'll press the S button to stop recording. And finally, I will press the P button to watch the replay. It works! This is just the beginning of what you can do with this replay system. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments section. I'll do my best to answer all of them. Hopefully you found this tutorial useful. I have some very exciting videos coming up that you won't want to miss, so make sure to like and subscribe. See you next time.